learning English helps me to talk about my cooking.
SBS acknowledges the traditional custodians of country and their connections and continuous care for the skies, lands and waterways throughout Australia. Hi, I'm Josipa. A few weeks ago, my mom came to visit me from Croatia. Since she arrived, actually from the moment she unpacked her suitcase, she also unpacked all her kitchen secrets. And we've been cooking together non-stop. The best part of our time together? Well, as we slice, dice and mix our way through the dishes of my childhood, we talk a lot. And I think my cooking has also improved. With my mom by my side, learning her cooking secrets has become as easy as pie. When we say something is as easy as pie, it means it's very easy to do. This seems like a funny expression because a lot of people don't find making a pie very easy. But it is for people like my mom. And the phrases we are going to practice in this episode will make talking about cooking as easy as pie. Or we can also say a piece of cake. Yep, you guessed it. When we say something is a piece of cake, we also mean it's very easy to do. Look at that, we haven't even started and we already have two phrases to say that something is easy to do. It's as easy as pie and it's a piece of cake. And the thing I like the most about these phrases is that we can use them to talk about anything, not just cooking. But for now, let's go into our imaginary kitchen, where Alan and Claire are cooking up a storm. A storm, you might wonder. Yes, English can be quite playful when it comes to cooking phrases. The phrase, cooking up a storm, is a fun way to say that someone is cooking a lot of food. It's like they're putting so much energy into their cooking that it could make a storm. Let's hear Alan and Claire.
I love how versatile Anzac biscuits are.
Here's a little tip. I like to mix it up by tossing in almonds and cranberries.
Oh, I love that idea. And maybe a sprinkle of pumpkin seeds for an extra bit of texture.
Sounds delicious. We can make a few different batches to see which combo we like best.
Definitely. Let's also try one with dark chocolate chips. They'll give a nice rich flavour that will complement the cranberries perfectly.
Just talking about these biscuits is mouth-watering. If something is mouth-watering, it looks, sounds or smells so good that it makes you hungry so that your mouth waters just thinking about it, or in this case, just talking about it. Well, it turns out that Alan and Claire are putting a creative twist on Anzac biscuits. That is, they're making new and wonderful changes to the recipe because Claire said,
I love how versatile Anzac biscuits are.
Anzac biscuits have a special place in Australian history. They were originally made during World War I for Anzac soldiers, that is, Australian and New Zealand Army Corps. The original recipe was designed to create biscuits that would last the long journey to reach the soldiers. Claire said that Anzac biscuits are versatile. If a dish or recipe is versatile, it means you can make changes to it, like using different ingredients, and it will still turn out good.
Here's a little tip. I like to mix it up by tossing in almonds and cranberries.
Here's a little tip. You can say this anytime when you want to share some advice that you think someone will find helpful. My tip for learning English is to keep listening to this episode. Let's hear Alan's advice once again.
I like to mix it up by tossing in almonds and cranberries.
To mix it up means to change things to make them more interesting. To toss in something means to add something to a mix. So we heard that Alan likes to make Anzac biscuits more interesting by tossing in some almonds and cranberries.
Oh, I love that idea. And maybe a sprinkle of pumpkin seeds for an extra bit of texture?
When we talk about food, the texture is how it feels when you eat it. For example, adding pumpkin seeds or nuts to a cake can make it crunchy, so that it is not only soft, but also feels a little bit hard. And if you sprinkle something into your food, you add small amounts of something lightly over your dish. Alan also said,
"We can make a few different batches to see which combo we like best."
A batch is a group of something, in this case biscuits, made at the same time. So to make something in batches means to make it in a series of separated groups, one after the other. Alan is suggesting that each batch should use a slightly different recipe so that they can see what combo works best. Do you know what Alan means by combo? That's just a short word for combination.
Definitely. Let's also try one with dark chocolate chips. They'll give a nice rich flavor that will complement the cranberries perfectly.
They'll give a nice rich flavor that will complement the cranberries. Notice how Claire makes a prediction about how the chocolate chips will improve the flavor of the biscuits. She says they'll give a nice flavor, and she's pretty sure that they will complement the flavor of the cranberries. When one ingredient complements another, it means that it goes well with it, and so they taste good together and make the dish taste better. For example, I could say that the cinnamon complements the sweetness of the apple pie perfectly. But we can use the word complement when talking about other things, not just cooking. Let's say you painted your living room. You could say the new color in the living room complements the furniture really well. Or I could say that Alan's calm nature complements Claire's energetic personality. So they make a great team. And speaking of Alan and Claire, let's listen to their conversation one more time. After that, I've got a really sweet surprise for you.
I love how versatile Anzac biscuits are.
Here's a little tip. I like to mix it up by tossing in almonds and cranberries.
Oh, I love that idea. And maybe a sprinkle of pumpkin seeds for an extra bit of texture.
Sounds delicious. We can make a few different batches to see which combo we like best.
Definitely. Let's also try one with dark chocolate chips. They'll give a nice rich flavor that will complement the cranberries perfectly.
Every year, people all over the world celebrate Ramadan. Ramadan is a month-long Muslim tradition of prayer and reflection and fasting. Fasting is when you don't drink or eat for a specific period of time. And even though Ramadan is about fasting, I've noticed my Muslim friends can't stop talking about food during this period. Ravi, you are one of those friends.
Yes, I am. Well, I guess it's like if you've been fasting for like 12 hours, it's very hard not to think about food. And that's why you can see people like talking a lot about food during the fasting period. But after the first few days of fasting, it becomes much easier and people don't think about food as much.
Well, all I hear throughout the day is how sweet the dates are, how spicy the samosas get.
Absolutely. Like, it's just, you think about the fasting and Ramadan and the food. It's, you can't really just, you know, put them like, it's all one package, if it does make sense. And it's kind of like you enjoy that sense of belonging and like sharing a meal with your loved ones.
Rami, you create many engaging videos for SBS Arabic, and I noticed your recent video focuses on food. Can you tell me a bit more about it?
Absolutely. Like my latest story was with this beautiful Syrian chef, like and it was more like the food, of course, was always in the background, but like the story of this migrant bringing all the nostalgia of Ramadan and how like her experience as a migrant experiencing Ramadan in Australia compared to like her home country. And the way that she's presenting the food, the dishes, the traditions, the decorations that are in her house and in her kitchen, that all gives the vibes of Ramadan and festivities another level. And of course, all those mouth-watering, beautiful Syrian dishes that we've got to enjoy and see.
Thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you very much.
It's time to practice. See if you remember the meaning before hearing the answer. If somebody is cooking up a storm, they are...
If somebody is cooking up a storm, they are cooking a lot of lovely food with skill and passion.
If something is mouth-watering, it is...
If something is mouth-watering, it looks, sounds, or smells so good that it makes you hungry so that your mouth waters. Just thinking about it.
Let's now practice talking about cooking by repeating after Alan and Claire.
I love how versatile Anzac biscuits are.
I like to mix it up by tossing in almonds and cranberries.
And maybe a sprinkle of pumpkin seeds for an extra bit of texture.
We can make a few different batches to see which combo we like best.
On our website sbs.com.au/learnenglish, you can find transcripts and learning notes for this episode. And if you would like to get in touch, follow us on Facebook. We are SBS Learn English. I'm Josipa. Thank you for learning English with me.
This is the SBS Learn English podcast.